In the world of injection mold making, it's virtually impossible to look at a part and say, yeah, that's ready to mold. That's why TopSolid'Mold exists. Here, we're going to start by importing our plastic part into TopSolid'Mold. We'll say direct positioning, and here TopSolid has our back. It says, hey, you forgot to add shrink. You might want to do that. Here, we'll set it to 5,000 shrink, and like that, the part has been loaded with shrink. Next, maybe we want to analyze the part a little bit more. For example, are there any undercuts in this model? And with a simple click of the mouse, you see highlighted in red those undercuts. From here, maybe we want to analyze minimum draft angles. So we can set a draft angle, select the part, and then analyze those faces locally to make sure that they all have the proper draft angles. From here, maybe the next step would be to calculate the projected area that is required to mold this part. So again, we just select a simple function, we choose the direction, and like that, we give you the projected area. Yet still, there's times when you want to take that analysis a step further. And that's why we've partnered with CADMould for mold flow analysis and coolant analysis. So here we're going to open up a more completed design, and we'll show you a little bit about the design and then how you can send this into CADMould. First, we'll start by opening mold visualization, and we're going to turn off aspects of the core block, turn on just the cavity block, maybe some inserts. Then maybe we'll turn those off. Oh, pardon me, we'll turn those on. Now we see the entire assembly. Like that, we can also see solid models of our coolant lines. Maybe we want to turn off the cavity block again. And now we'll export to CADMould. For this sample, we'll set a relatively loose tolerance. And we'll just say OK. And like that, TopSolid'Mold is preparing the data for CADMould and then launching CADMould directly. And here in a few seconds, we'll see CADMould load up. Here we see our coolant lines. Next, we'll see our parts to analyze. And from here then, you could use the tools within CADMould to run further analysis on these parts, whether it's for mold flow analysis or cooling analysis.